Euclids Elements of Geometry, the Greek text of J.L. Heiberg, 1883-1885. Introduction. Euclid's Elements is by far the most famous mathematical work of classical antiquity, and also has the distinction of being the world's oddest continuously used mathematical textbook. Little is known about the author, beyond the fact that he lived in Alexandria around 300 BCE. The main subjects of the work are geometry, proportion, and number theory. Most of the theorems appearing in the Elements were not discovered by Euclid himself, but were the work of earlier Greek mathematicians such as Pythagoras and his school, Hippocrates of Chios, Theaetetus of Athens, and Eudoxus of Cnidos. However, Euclid is generally credited with arranging these theorems in a logical manner so as to demonstrate admittedly, not always with the rigor demanded by modern mathematics, that they necessarily follow from five simple axioms. Euclid is also credited with devising a number of particularly ingenious proofs of previously discovered theorems, e.g. Theorem 48 in Book 1. The geometrical constructions employed in the Elements are restricted to those which can be achieved using a straight rule and a compass. Furthermore, empirical proofs by means of measurement are strictly forbidden, i.e., any comparison of two magnitudes is restricted to saying that the magnitudes are either equal or that one is greater than the other. The Elements consists of 13 books. Book 1 outlines the fundamental propositions of plane geometry, including the three cases in which triangles are congruent, various theorems involving parallel lines, the theorem regarding the sum of the angles in a triangle, and a Pythagorean theorem. Book 2 is commonly said to deal with geometric algebra, since most of the theorems contained within it have simple algebraic interpretations. Book 3 investigates circles and their properties, and includes theorems on tangents and inscribed angles. Book 4 is concerned with regular polygons inscribed in and circumscribed around circles. Book 5 develops the arithmetic theory of proportion. Book 6 applies the theory of proportion to plane geometry, and contains the theorems on similar figures. Book 7 deals with elementary number theory, e.g. prime numbers, greatest common denominators, etc. Book 8 is concerned with geometric series. Book 9 contains various applications of results in the previous two books, and includes theorems on the infinitude of prime numbers, as well as the sum of a geometric series. Book 10 attempts to classify incommensurable, i.e. irrational magnitudes using the so-called method of exhaustion, an ancient precursor to integration. Book 11 deals with the fundamental propositions of three-dimensional geometry. Book 12 calculates the relative volumes of cones, pyramids, cylinders, and spheres using the method of exhaustion. Finally, Book 13 investigates the five so-called Platonic solids. This edition of Euclid's Elements presents the definitive Greek text, i.e., that edited by J.L. Heiberg, 1883-85, accompanied by a modern English translation, as well as a Greek-English lexicon. Neither the spurious books 14 and 15, nor the extensive scholia which have been added to the Elements over the centuries, are included. The aim of the translation is to make the mathematical argument as clear and unambiguous as possible, whilst still adhering closely to the meaning of the original Greek text. Within square parentheses in both Greek and English indicates material identified by Heiberg as being later interpolations to the original text. Some particularly obvious or unhelpful interpolations have been omitted altogether. Text within round parenthesis in English indicates material which is implied, but not actually present, in the Greek text. My thanks to Marius Vortzicki Berkeley for typesetting advice, and to Sam Watson and Jonathan Fino, U Mississippi, and Gregory Wong, UCSD, for pointing out a number of errors in Book 1. Elements, Book 1. Fundamentals of plane geometry involving straight lines. Definitions. 1. A point is that of which there is no part. 2. And a line is a length without breadth. 3. And the extremities of a line are points. 4. A straight line is anyone which lies evenly with points on itself. 5. And a surface is that which has length and breadth only. 6. And the extremities of a surface are lines. 7. A plane surface is anyone which lies evenly with the straight lines on itself. 8. And a plane angle is the inclination of the lines to one another. When two lines in a plane meet one another and are not lying in a straight line. 9. And when the lines containing the angle are straight, then the angle is called rectilinear. 10. And when a straight line stood upon another straight line makes adjacent angles which are equal to one another, each of the equal angles is a right angle. And the former straight line is called a perpendicular to that upon which it stands. 11. An obtuse angle is one greater than a right angle. 12. And an acute angle is one less than a right angle. 13. A boundary is that which is the extremity of something. 14. A figure is that which is contained by some boundary or boundaries. 15. A circle is a plane figure contained by a single line which is called a circumference, such that all of the straight lines radiating towards the circumference from one point amongst those lying inside the figure are equal to one another. 16. And the point is called the center of the circle. 17. And the diameter of the circle is any straight line, being drawn through the center and terminated in each direction by the circumference of the circle. And any such straight line also cuts the circle in half. 18. And a semicircle is the figure contained by the diameter and the circumference cut off by it. And the center of the semicircle is the same point as the center of the circle. 19. Rectilinear figures are those figures contained by straight lines, trilateral figures being those contained by three straight lines, quadrilateral by four, and multilateral by more than four. 20. And of the trilateral figures, an equilateral triangle is that having three equal sides, an isosceles triangle that having only two equal sides, and a scalene triangle that having three unequal sides. 21. And further of the trilateral figures, a right-angled triangle is that having a right angle, an obtuse angle triangle that having an obtuse angle, and an acute-angled triangle that having three acute angles. 22. And of the quadrilateral figures, a square is that which is right-angled and equilateral, a rectangle that which is right-angled but not equilateral, a rhombus that which is equilateral but not right-angled, and a rhomboid that having opposite sides and angles equal to one another, which is neither right-angled nor equilateral. And let quadrilateral figures besides these be called trapezia. 23. Parallel lines are straight lines which, being in the same plane, and being produced to infinity in each direction, meet with one another in neither of these directions. Postulates. 1. Let it have been postulated to draw a straight line from any point to any point. 2. And to produce a finite straight line continuously in a straight line. 3. And to draw a circle with any center and radius. 4. And that all right angles are equal to one another. 5. And that if a straight line falling across two other straight lines makes internal angles on the same side of itself whose sum is less than two right angles, then the two other straight lines, being produced to infinity, meet on that side of the original straight line, that the sum of the internal angles is less than two right angles, and do not meet on the other side. Common notions. 1. Things equal to the same thing are also equal to one another. 2. And if equal things are added to equal things, then the wholes are equal. 3. And if equal things are subtracted from equal things, then the remainders are equal. 4. And things coinciding with one another are equal to one another. 5. And the whole is greater than the part.